I coach kids too, which is weird. All right. I saw that a friend of a friend had invited me to a Facebook event. It was about brown girls and going out to a bar for a Beyonce theme night. I turned a few thoughts over in my mind, a handful of pennies whose facets had worn smooth years ago. Are we all supposed to be into going out and hanging out with strangers? Are we not supposed to be anxious about social settings? Black girls aren't allowed to be depressed. We're barely allowed to be noticed. We're not supposed to be anxious. We're just loud social creatures, right? Black women are supposed to be strong and independent. We're supposed to find strength in our isolation. Black girls can't be depressed, so I never knew how to tell my mom that most days I felt like I was floating away, and I was so numb that I couldn't feel my memories, everything that felt like me seeping out of me like sweat in a bathhouse. A general sense of melancholy is met with choruses of self-care. Every beat of me that broke swept to a pile with the rest of the careless crumbs of recollection and dusty layers of distress. My heart broke on the doorstep every time I crossed the threshold to fill another day in my duty as a normal black girl. Lavender bubble bath and India Ree singing my soul song could only do so much. I've always been afraid to address my anxiety because I've never been diagnosed. Like I needed someone else's tongue to wrap their tongue around my mind and roll me around in their cheeks. Like I needed another saliva to dip between my creases and folds and wrinkles and unearth my layers like I'm a goddamn jawbreaker just to tell me how I feel. But I needed someone to tell me how to feel. I had lost myself to my reflection. I would stand in the bathroom in front of a sink, staring into a pair of unfamiliar eyes and wondering why the girl who moved like me knew where we came from and if we could go back. Maybe if we went back, it wouldn't hurt so much. Maybe if we could stop crying, we could figure out why it didn't hurt anywhere, but everything felt like an excavation of several dermal layers from a gravity treadmill being dragged perpetually beneath us, or us along it. I don't even know what tense to write this in. I no longer puzzle in front of sinks or underbuzzing bathroom lights. I resign myself to my timeline of forgotten fragments. Forever hopeful I can rewrite the accounts that I've lost and polish the stories that have stayed. Black girls can't be depressed, so we trade in storybook tales of medieval royalty for Nash narratives, spoken in an imperfect and irregular body language. We live out a dance exhaling conviction into a choreographed sanity. It is hope and expression and relief, but it's dangerous. My black body isn't as it is supposed to be. It sways in rhythms, acquiescing to the assurance that these rituals will continue. And we will continue to rewrite our own regulations. Now get formation.